Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Saturday. Today is Saturday, January 27th. We're almost at the end of the month of January. Woo! Wow, time is going quickly. Today, I started off today with We Fall Down, and that is a praise song, and that was Maranatha Music off of their top 50 praise songs. So hope you enjoy that. Today we are going to continue on. We're going to do Psalm 50 again, except this time we're going to add a few more verses. So we're looking at Psalm 50 verses 1 through 6 today. And thank you, Catherine, for reminding us about praise. So that was yesterday. We're going to talk today about how we hide. Let me say good morning to all of you. It's good to be with you this morning. Good morning, Barbara and Michelle. I'm glad you're both with us this morning. Praying for each of you as we begin this day. And Janet and Daniel, good to have you here. Holding you both in prayer this morning. Good morning, Jerry and Catherine. I'm glad you're here, ready for a day of praising God. Praying for both of you today. Good morning, Susan and Donna. I'm glad you're both with us. Praying for each of you this morning. Good morning, Blanca and Jacqueline. I'm glad you're both with us. Praying for you this morning. And Kathy and Marilyn, welcome. Holding both of you in prayer today. Good morning, Megan and Beatrice. It's good to have you here. Praying for each of you. And Andrea and Augusta. I'm glad you're with us, holding you both in prayer today. And good morning, Debbie. And I don't see Al, but I'm going to say Al just in case he's there. Good morning, Debbie and Al. It's good to have you both here, praying for each of you as well as we start the day off. So as I said earlier, we're going to be looking at Psalm 50, and I'm going to be reading verses 1 through 6. So I invite you to open up your Bibles. If this is your first time here, it doesn't look like there are anybody here for the first time, but if you are, I encourage you, we do open our Bibles, so bring your Bible when you come. But I'm going to read it for you, verses 1 through 6, Psalm 50. So as you're opening your Bibles, my name is Cindy Stauffer. I am blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. And I'm so glad. Wonderful. Good morning. Getting ready to go walking. Yes, it's Saturday walking day. I know you walk other days too, but Saturday is a big day. So praying for a great walk today. So welcome. I'm glad you're here. It's good for us to start each day with God's word, seeking God and being in prayer for one another. And so I'm glad you're here with us today. So let's take a look. Psalm 50, 1 through 6. The mighty one, God, the Lord, speaks and summons the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting. Out of Zion, the perfection of beauty, God shines forth. Our God comes and does not keep silence. Before him is a devouring fire and a mighty tempest all around him. He calls to the heavens above and to the earth that he may judge his people. Gather to me, my faithful ones, who made a covenant with me by sacrifice. The heavens declare his righteousness, for God himself is judge. Good morning, Myrna. I'm glad you're here. Keeping you in prayer today. Okay, so we're moving on in the Upper Room book, Upper Room Disciplines 2024. And this week we've been working with Kristen Stone King, who is a superintendent in the Bay District in San Francisco. So let's continue on with her today. It feels good to focus on the glory of God and the beauty of God's creation. The God of unconditional love is popular. We like to talk about God, the God of unconditional love. But what of God the judge? Life can be challenging. And in our struggles, we may want to hide from God. We may feel defensive at our sense of inadequacy or about the times that we have not been our best selves. The paradox is that God does not judge our struggles, but our hiding. God knows that with which we struggle. God knows when we have fallen short of the glory of God. We are seen at all times, at our best and at our worst. God asks us to continually bring all before God in humility and reverence. The psalmist reminds ancient Israel of their covenant with God. A covenant is not like a contract. In a covenant, the participants uphold their commitment, seeking unbroken relationship in spite of the behavior of the other. However, God is not silent when the covenant is broken. God calls us back into covenantal relationship at all times. How are we upholding our covenant to bring all of our lives before God? Do we trust God enough to be seen in all of our humanness? Do we accept that we are not God, and therefore we are always fallible? In God's continual calling out to us and seeking to enfold us in covenant, we find the grace of unconditional love. God, the judge, is necessarily also the God of unconditional love. Yeah, we don't like to talk about God as judge. And I think because we miss the point of being in relationship with God. Our tendency is to think to be in relationship is to get it right all the time. But I mean, how many of us have a relationship where we get it right all the time? The best relationships aren't the ones that are perfect and never make mistakes. The best relationships are the ones that stay communicating, stay trying, stay present, okay? If you think about it, a husband and wife don't have a good relationship because they never make mistakes. They have a good relationship because they continue to walk through even those challenging times. When God calls us into covenant, God is calling us into relationship. And so what God wants more than anything is for God, for us to bring our full selves, even when we go the wrong way, even when we mess up, screw up, whatever word you want to use. When we break covenant and that's not what I wanted to say. What I wanted to say is even when we lose our way, God wants us to still bring our full selves, to stay in connection, right? Because that's the most important thing. There are days when I fail. If I hide from God, it is as if I'm cutting myself off from that relationship. And real sin is to cut ourselves off from relationship with God and one another. So I know I'm belaboring the point, but we do it so often. How many times do we think we've got to get it right before we go to church? You know, I've made these mistakes. I better get my life right before I step into church or before I go back to the community. I got to get it right before I get on my knees and pray. No, no, no. You need community. That we need to be in deeper connection with God, even more in those times where we are struggling. That is when we need God. That is when we need one another. We need God. We need one another all the time, but especially in those times. And friends, we think we, when we hide, that somehow we're pulling one over on God or on the people that love us, and we're not. We're not. If we are going to live fully, then we need to stay in connection. The cross reminds us of the deep importance of a vertical connection with God and a horizontal connection with one another. That is what it means to live faithfully. And that is what God longs for us, each one of us, so much so that God came here to take on humanity, to experience what we've experienced so that we would know that we're not alone. So stop running. God sees, God knows. Turn back to God, turn back to the community of God, and know that you're not alone. Whatever you're walking through, so many of us have and continue to walk through. What God wants for you is to stop hiding and come home. And the good news is God is waiting to welcome you. The God of unconditional love is waiting to welcome you home. Let's pray. God, we come today acknowledging that for too long we have ran away. We have hidden ourselves away. We have not trusted you with our whole heart. We have not loved you as you continually love us. We have not cared for our neighbor, for the needs of those around us. Forgive us, Lord, and lead us back. Help us to know that not only are we seen, but we are deeply loved. That there is nothing, nothing that can separate us from your love. Nothing we have done, nothing we will do in the future will separate us from the power of your love. Help us to stop running, stop hiding, stop trying to put on some sort of image to the world. Help us to come before you, to fall down, to lay our crowns at your feet, and know that we are loved beyond measure. Lord, I pray for each person on the call today, that they will hear your call today, that they will know that they don't need to hide any longer, that just whatever they're facing, that they don't have to face it alone, that you want to walk with them, that the community of God, the church, Christ's body, we want to walk with them. Lord, help us to love you more fully and to love our neighbor, to stay in relationship, to keep the covenant. We ask all of this in your name, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So let's stop hiding. The God that loves you calls you home. Not because you're perfect, but because you're loved. God loves you, my friends, and so do I. So I want to invite you to tune in for worship or join us for worship tomorrow. I think it will be an important time for the life of our church. And so I hope you can be with us tomorrow morning at 11. In person would be perfect, but if you are only able to come in on live stream, that's okay. I'm glad you'll be there, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Worship is 11. We're going to be talking about holy conferencing, but there are some other things that are going to be happening in the midst of worship, so love to have you be a part of that time. So have a blessed day, and I will see you tomorrow at 11. Bye, friends.